is my first Periscope. My name is Peggy Durham. I'm a Sensuous Life Coach and a Health and Wellness Life Coach. Today I'm going to talk about keeping your knees healthy, which is critical pretty much. And the older you get, the more important it becomes. So I've had knee problems for about 10 years, or actually one knee. And about 6 years ago, I met a great physical therapist who showed me these knee exercises. And I want to share them with you as something that you might be able to use in your workouts to help keep your knees healthy. You might want to check with your doctor to see if it's okay, or your physical therapist. But if you do things that don't cause pain, generally it works. Anyway, so I'm going to start with my knee exercises. The first ones are pretty easy. You just find somewhere comfortable to lay down. And the first one is you're just going up and back with your leg and just keeping your knee straight. I do about, well, sometimes my sock comes off. I do about 20 of these on one leg. You can do whatever you want to do while you're doing this. Listen to music. Watch TV almost. So I do three sets of 20 on each foot, on each leg. You're actually going to want to press down on your heel just a little bit when you come back. And this helps tracking of your knee. Works well on carpet or any kind of mat. If you do it, sometimes a sock works better. Okay, so that's the first exercise. The second exercise is a little bit harder, and it has several things you need to pay attention to while you're doing it. First thing is you stretch out as far as you can on to the right side, and you're going to flex your foot and then press down your knee into the carpet or the mat. So the concentration is keeping your leg flexed all the way down and pressing your knee down as you move it. So it's like this. Pulling it in and then back out. Pulling it in. Focus being, again, pressing the knee down as you bring it across. Don't forget to breathe. Again, I do 20 of these. Actually, I do three sets of 20. Now, I've lost track of count, but when you do 20 on one leg, then you switch, and you might need to scoot over. Scoot over so you have a lot of room to pull out. This is my leg that has had problems through the years, and it wants to not lay flat, and that's the goal for me. As long as I do my knee exercises, I feel great. So again, the goal of this one is to press your knee down, push it down as you come across. That's one, two, one. Again, the whole time I'm thinking about pressing this knee down. And this knee has more problems, so it wants to come up sort of like this. I'm not sure exactly why, but pressing that down as I pull it across, it kind of helps the whole hip area get more stable. And it's it's really the best exercise of all for me. So when I don't do it every other day, my knee, it's harder to do. When I do it every day, it's easy. So my goal is to do it every day. So anyway, the next exercise is a core exercise, basically. Until I started doing these particular core exercises, I never really understood the whole core thing. But basically, this exercise causes you to have strong legs, abs, butt. So it kind of covers everything. So when I first started doing these, my physical therapist, whose name is Matt Lee, showed me these exercises. And he said he wanted me to do 3 sets of 20. And I think I did 1 or 2. And I told him he was crazy. So be patient with yourself if you've never done exercises on a ball. It requires a lot of focus and a lot of concentration to kind of just get everything organized here. Okay, so this is the deal. You have your foot up here and you flex your feet. You put your hands down for a little stability or relax them over here, whichever one you feel like you need to do. Okay, flex your feet, and then what you're going to do is just go up with your butt. If you want to make sure you're going straight, you can always just put your hands right here to make sure that you're going up and down straight as possible. And of course, when you first start doing this, your legs are going to want to do this. So again, the key is to tighten your abs, tighten your butt, tighten your legs, and just go up and down very slowly. And then basically you're flexing your butt when you do this and tightening everything in here. And you're working all these muscles, so you're going to get really tight ab muscles. So what you want to do is 3 sets of 20 on that again. We'll just do a few more. So, and that'll get easier over time, so just be patient with that. The next exercise is, again, you pull the ball closer, you flex your feet like this, and you're going to push down into your feet and up. This, again, is a hard one, but once you get it, it's easy, all right? But be patient. Just start with a few, okay? So, you're pressing the ball down, making it stay. Your feet about hips width apart, leg ankles flexed. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so that one I usually do 10 at a time because it's a lot harder. And if you keep doing them, your legs, your bottom, your abs, everything will get really tight. And your knees will stay healthy. So, other things that I do for my knees, let's see, I take some supplements. I take turmeric and fish oil, definitely. I've also been using some essential oils. These are Young Living essential oils. This week I'm using nutmeg and frankincense. They help keep my knee healthy, and I'd highly recommend them. I'm also the author of this book. It's called Be Your Own Sensuous Life Coach. And my website is sensuouslifecoach.com. So check it out. I'm going to be doing a lot more Periscopes with... Actually, I'm going to read from my book. The way I wrote this book is you can pick it up anytime. And like every page is a different thing to read. So, good for people like me, you just want to pick up a magazine article and just read it. And until next time, thanks.